Would you all please rise?
Rebel, devil, you're long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough for you. Forget the world now, you won't let them see. But there's one thing left for me. That the weight has lifted.
Celebrate love. Brian and Sam have not only opened their hearts to each other, they've also opened their hearts to us to share this most sacred and personal event as they join their lives and theirs. For those of you that are here today, your spouse, your partner, I encourage you to let this ceremony be a reminder, and that it's a rededication of the love and the commitment that you share during our marriage. On behalf of Brian and Sammy, thank you all for being here to witness their ceremony. Reports to our bride. At this time, I'd ask, who brings this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. And you may all be seated. Thank you so much. Of all the needs that we encounter, one of our greatest is the need for connection and relationship. A close and loving relationship provides a calm, warm protection when the world outside is cold and uncertain. Marriage offers us a relationship unlike any other. A relationship where two people can find an emotional and spiritual bond that grows stronger and more secure with each passing year. The wonder of true love that lasts a lifetime. It must happen. It comes from within. It comes from the hearts of two people that truly love each other. And I have no doubt that Brian and Sammy have indeed connected their hearts one to the other. The foundation of this relationship is, of course, commitment, but it also comes from a much deeper understanding that an enduring relationship is built upon true friendship. True friendship means accepting and respecting somebody else's uniqueness. True friendship nurtures our hopes, our aspirations, and encourages us to be the best person we possibly can to each other. Brian and Sammy, your wedding today is together. And so on this day, your wedding day, simply confirms with your heart time ago to be supportive and encouraging, caring for each other with sensitivity and tenderness. You have found that one special person with whom you can pursue all those dreams that you now hold and all those dreams yet to come. Be thankful for the ways in which you balance and complement each other. Never forget all of those wonderful qualities that first drew you two together. Your marriage will present an array of opportunities to refine and strengthen this relationship. Celebrate all the happiness, all the success life brings your way, and always show each other that you can be trusted and counted on for comfort during difficult times. Remember that your relationship is alive, never changing. It's always inviting you to explore and rediscover life's great adventure. Let your love lead the way and guide you in everything that you do. One of the most poignant descriptions of what love is and what we should all aspire to in our own relationships can be found in the Bible. In 1 Corinthians, the Apostle Paul wrote, "Love is patient, very kind. It knows no jealousy, gives itself no greater errors. It's never rude, selfish, irritated, or resentful. Love is gladdened by goodness, always slow, expose the worst, and always eager to believe the best. Always hopeful, patient, and love never disappears. Faith, hope, and love last on. But of these three, the greatest is love." It's that kind of love that brought you two together. It's that same wonderful love that can keep you together for the rest of your lives. When I met with Brian and Sammy to talk about their wedding and their ceremony, what they might like to include in, I asked them if they'd like to say something to each other in front of their family and friends to let everybody know just how they feel about each other. And they agreed to this. So Brian, I'll turn it over to you.
First. Beer and baseball. I should have known from day one at the Royals game that I'd be marrying you. But normally I don't expect anything good from going to a Royals game. The last few years have been quite a journey. Lawrence to Odessa and finally in San Antonio. The sacrifices you've made for this relationship have not gone unnoticed. Waitressing, working at the retirement home, and taking on the role of full-time wedding planner. You've been unbelievable. You are so kind and caring, and I cannot wait for you to be my wife. You are already my best friend.
Seems like just yesterday, we were two strangers going to a Royals game. Who would have thought that would lead to this day? You won me over with beer and baseball. You're such an amazing person, and I am truly honored to become your wife. We have had quite the adventure so far. Two moves, no jobs, new jobs. And while people may think that sounds stressful, we managed to make it fun. I can't wait to continue this adventure with you. I know it won't always be easy, but I know having you by my side, we can make it through anything. I love you, and I'm so excited to have you as my husband.
Sooner or later, we come to understand that love is something much more than just verses on Valentine's or simple infatuation. We realize that true love is here and now, that it is the most important thing in our lives. Love is this wonderful and eternal force that brings two people together. It's love that leads us to our true destination. Brian and Sammy, this honest and real love that you found in each other has now led you to your true destination. So, as you stand here today, in front of your family and friends, eager to embrace this new chapter in your lives, I'd like to remind you that the hands you're now holding are the ones through the years when you need each other's strength. And the eyes you have to look into are the ones that can fill your hearts with a very special warmth that can only come from sharing this journey together. The reason that you two are here today is because of the both of you do honestly believe in this promise of love that has no end. And so, Brian, if you'd repeat after me. I, Brian, take you, Sammy.
I, Brian, take you, Sammy.
To be my wife, my partner in life.
To be my wife, my partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish and respect you.
I will cherish and respect you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully.
Loving you faithfully.
Through all that life may bring.
Through all that life may bring.
To share with you every joy.
To share with you every joy.
And stand by you at every challenge.
And stand by you at every challenge.
I give you my hand.
I give you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my love.
And my love.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
And Sammy, if you too would repeat after me. I, Sammy, take you, Brian.
I, Sammy, take you, Brian.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish and respect you.
I will cherish and respect you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully.
Loving you faithfully.
Through all that life may bring.
Through all that life may bring.
To share with you every joy.
Share with you every joy.
And stand by you at every challenge.
Stand by you at every challenge.
I give you my hand.
Give you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my love.
And my love.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
As long as we both shall live. Brian and Sammy, may these promises of love and commitment that you two have just shared bring a new kind of togetherness that lasts a lifetime. May that be a good long time for the both of you. Let this relationship always be a beautiful retreat, that it's far removed from the cares of this world. May you never ever take one another for granted. May your home always be filled with love, laughter, and peace. And now, if I may have Sammy. From time immemorial, wedding bands have been used to seal this most sacred of all covenants. These are visible testaments of this pure and endless devotion. So Brian, as you place this ring on Sammy's finger, if you would once again repeat after me. Sammy, this ring is the symbol of my love.
Sammy, this ring is the symbol of my love.
And pride that you are my wife.
And pride that you are my wife.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And Sammy, if you too would repeat after me as you place this ring on Brian's finger. Brian, this ring is the symbol of my love.
Brian, this ring is the symbol of my love.
And pride that you are my husband.
And pride that you are my husband.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
By the giving and receiving of these rings, these are your gifts of true love to each other. You do each other wed. These marriage vows are now forever sealed. At this time, I'd like to offer a prayer for our new couple. God, we know you've heard these promises of love and devotion that Brian and Sammy have made to each other. We ask for your blessing on their family and marriage, with an abundance of guidance and wisdom that strengthens this love and this relationship. Let their lives be filled with happiness, success, and for each of us here today, may our lives be enriched and blessed for having shared in this celebration. Amen. Brian and Sammy have elected, as a symbol of the joining of their lives, to combine individual bases of sand into one. The individual containers behind me represent all the uniqueness, all the experiences that they're going to bring to this marriage. As it would be impossible to separate the grains of sand from the single vase, let this gesture remind them that just as there is constant change within this relationship, it's also constant change within these grains of sand. Let it also ensure that just as these grains will be forever united, they too will be forever united. Brian and Sammy, if you would. Now, Brian and Sammy would like to make a special presentation to two very special ladies, their mothers, for all the influence and all the support they've received throughout their lives. And now, I'd like to offer a reading that Brian and Sammy have chosen for their ceremony today, entitled, The Art of Marriage. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, I love you, every day. It's never going to sleep angry. It's having mutual values and common objectives. Forming a circle of love that now encompasses another family. It's speaking words of appreciation, demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's having the capacity to forgive and forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which each can continue to grow. It's finding room for the things of the spirit. It's a common search for the good and the beautiful in this life, but now hand in hand with your very best friend. You see, it's not only marrying the right partner, but it's also about being the right partner. Brian, Sammy's greatest deed throughout the rest of her life will be that you love her with all of your heart, and I'm sure you will. She needs to know that she'll never be in competition with another person or interest for your attention or affection. She needs to know that the truth is only one name. That name is hers. And Sammy Bryan's greatest need throughout the rest of his life will be that you two love him with all of your heart. I'm sure you will. He needs to know that you believe in him and appreciate all that he is and all that he can become. He needs to know that from this day on, he will be the only man in your life. The love that you two have found is an amazing gift. Make it more important than anything else, and this will become your life's greatest reward. There's nothing in this world that can possibly match the memories of a life shared with the one you love. You two have every reason to believe that this love to which you've just pledged yourselves can and will last forever. So I do, by the authority vested in me, by the laws of the state of Arizona, by the grace of God above, pronounce you husband and wife. And the moment, Brian, you've waited for, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure and it's my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brian and Sammy Martinek. Congratulations.